In this video, I'm going to address the common question I keep getting. I've gotten this question over maybe 10 times. I kid you not. How to glide? Let me tell you guys, it's very simple. It's not hard at all. I promise you. Basically, all gliding is basically pitch bending. That's it. If you don't understand what pitch bending, I guess glide is a new term for pitch bending. Basically, it's this little knob that's all the way to the left side of your controller, because that's where it's usually placed. It just depends. It may be placed next to the keys itself on the same line, or it may be placed above your keys. It may be a button. It's several designs, you know, so it may be a toggle knob or a knob or up and down or a wheel or whatever. And next to that is usually your modeler wheel right here and right next to it, and you can have different effects. And they even gotten creative in 2016. Now they are touch sensitive, so don't be surprised if these touch sensitive strips that they're now making will control your garage door. So basically, in order to achieve this inside of your song, this is really, you know, all you need to do. So let's do something right quick. Now, there's obviously different parameters according to the different plugins you may have. For instance, I have Massive here. And if we are in this section here, which is down here at the bottom, if you're familiar with Massive, I'm down here at the oscillator tab here. And there's a section here called Glide. And next to that is Pitch Bend. Although I said they are essentially the same thing, it's really the same thing, but they have different parameters that you can punch in order to make your, you know, your situation do different things. So for instance, say, okay, here's the sound here. Now, all Glide does is allow you to go or down, you know, is pitch bending, is bending the pitch up or down depending on where you're going. Now the Glide feature inside of Massive, if I turn this up some, then if I do something like this, you know what I mean, it glides up or down. And so if I turn the time up, then check this out. And so it's but all of it, all it's doing is pitch bending. So I'm gonna put it back here. So if I hit my pitch bend, you know what I mean? It's doing the same thing. So basically, if I was to put this inside of a song, I'm gonna go ahead and find an 808 and I'm gonna show you exactly what I'm saying. Actually, what I'm gonna do is just play with this cutoff here and we'll work from there. That's good enough. Let's go. Keep it straight. All right. So here is one easy way. Well, for me, because I love playing around in automation mode. So in Studio One, seeing that that's what I'm working from, what I'm gonna do here is go to the pitch bend section here, and I may need to adjust the pitch bend situation here, the numbers, but let's get a bigger real estate here. So at 1.4 is when I want to go an octave down. So I'm going to put a node here, and then I'm going to put another node here. And we're going to make this come down. It should be 12. All right, so it's not 12 here. So it's... I'm going to put a node here, and I'm going to put another node here at the end. And then I'm gonna bring this back up to where it says zero. All right, so we got it at zero right here at bar three. That's one way of doing it. Or I could have did. So inside of massive, I can actually see 24, negative 24 is actually going further than where I'm trying to go. So let's go negative 12 instead. Now we can go negative 12 on here, I'm sure. So, you know what I mean? So if I go all the way down on my pitch bend, I can control. So I could do it like this. So let's duplicate this. I'm gonna mute this one here. So for instance, so you just have to remember to come up off the pitch bend before you hit the next note. So now what I need to, I didn't hit the note, the next note like I need to. So, you know, it's one of those things where it's a hit miss. This note here, first of all, I have both of these selected. That's why we're seeing all these crazy things going on. So, okay, so let's extend this note all the way out. And as you can see down here, we manually put that in there using our pitch bend. And I'm just showing you guys, this is what I'm doing. Each plugin is different. You know what I'm saying? But I'm just showing you guys how Glide is really pretty much pitch bending. And you see how they, you know, they coincide with each other. Glide, pitch bend. Glide is just another, I guess, an extension of what you can do, you know, in regards to pitch bend. If I want that perfect, the perfect bend, we're going to just make this go all the way down, and we're going to take this node right here and delete it. So let's listen back to that. You understand? And I had that slight glide right there before we went to that low A right there. So let's zoom in right there. And if that's what you're looking for, that's cool. But if not, I can always take this here and select this as well and move these back where it hits exactly on that, on, you know, bar three here. So now I have more so a straight note. Let's listen. And I have both of my notes here kind of overlapping, and that's why we still getting that glide effect. And then we're gonna also select them, and we're gonna quantize these here. We're gonna make these 100%, and let's see what happens. You know what I'm saying? So it just really depends on what you're trying to achieve. The glide feature is really cool. So let's add a nice little beat to it. 2, 3, 4. You know what I'm saying? I'm just playing around, doing something, filling it up a little bit. But I hope that helped you guys. Remember, music is art. You're the artist. Paint your picture. My name is Elup from ksign.com. Go to the website, sign up, put all of that good stuff in there, emails and such. All right, I'm out.